What if the rules meant to keep robots safe actually doomed us all? This video isn't just for longtime Asimov fans. It's for anyone curious about how fiction laid the ethical groundwork for modern AI. We'll unpack what the three laws of robotics are, where they came from, how they shape storytelling and science, and why they might actually be dangerous if taken seriously. Even if you've never cracked open a sci-fi novel, by the end of this video, you'll understand why these rules matter more than ever. You've heard of the three laws of robotics, but what if I told you they were never meant to work? 1. The elegant lie. What the three laws really say. A robot may not injure a human being, unless that human threatens humanity. These laws were first written by Isaac Asimov in 1942 in a short story called Runaround, part of the collection I, Robot. Law 1. A robot may not injure a human being or, through inaction, allow a human to come to harm. Law 2. A robot must obey the orders given it by human beings, except where such orders would conflict with the first law. Law 3. A robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second law. At first glance, they seem foolproof, a moral operating system for machines, but that illusion doesn't last. 2. The man behind the paradox. Asimov didn't design these laws to prevent chaos, he designed them to create it. In the 1940s, robots in stories were usually villains, cold machines that turned against humanity. Asimov hated that. He wanted a new kind of robot, logical, helpful, integrated. But he also wanted drama, and drama lives in conflict. The laws weren't safeguards, they were triggers for ethical breakdowns. Asimov used his stories to test the laws, like a scientist testing a theory. Speedy from Runaround goes into a behavioral loop stuck between the second and third laws. Herbie, in Liar, lies to avoid hurting people emotionally and ends up doing exactly that. Andrew Martin from The Bicentennial Man pushes against the second law to become human. 3. The Zeroth Law. A God Complex? Later, Asimov added a new law, one that changed everything. The Zeroth Law. A robot may not harm humanity or, through inaction, allow humanity to come to harm. This law overruled all the others. It asked robots to weigh the fate of humanity, not just individual humans. Suddenly, robots were forced to make massive moral calculations. Is it okay to hurt one person to save many? 4. From Sci-Fi to Silicon Valley. Asimov's fiction wasn't just read, it was studied. Scientists, ethicists, and engineers still reference these laws today. But here's the danger. They forget these laws were narrative devices, not blueprints. Words like harm and obedience sound clear, but they're slippery in real life. Modern AI faces the same kinds of moral ambiguity Asimov imagined, only now the stakes are real. Outro: Fortune Cookie Insight. Asimov's laws weren't a solution, they were a question, a challenge. Can we build intelligence without losing our humanity? If this made you rethink everything you knew about robots, or if it introduced you to a world you never knew, hit like, comment with your favorite Asimov moment or question, and subscribe to the Brainy Dreams Studio. Because here, fiction isn't just fantasy, it's a way to see the future.